previous lectures, we saw two inventory management models, the reorder point and the periodic review ones. The topic of this lecture is the optimization of both these models. With regard to the reorder point model, the optimization consists in finding the optimal fixed quantity to be ordered. This quantity is called EOQ, economic order quantity, since it is calculated by minimizing the sum of the relevant costs. The main relevant costs are the inventory carrying cost, the cost of the goods, the procurement cost, the transportation cost, and the cost of the stockout. Now we will see an example of EOQ optimization, which relies on three assumptions. Safety stock do not depend on Q, the quantity reordered. Q is delivered outright. Finally, the relevant costs considered are three, and namely the inventory carrying cost, the procurement cost, and the cost of the goods. First, the inventory carrying cost is the cost for keeping the products in the warehouse. Under the assumption that there are no safety stocks, the annual inventory carrying cost is calculated as the product among the cycle stocks, the unitary value of the item, and the inventory carrying cost expressed as a percentage of the item value. Second, the procurement cost is the cost linked to the order issuing. The annual procurement cost is calculated as the annual demand divided by the order quantity, which corresponds to the number of yearly orders placed, multiplied by the unitary procurement cost. Third, the cost of the goods is the cost related to the purchase or the production of the goods. The annual cost of goods is calculated as the product between the annual demand and the unitary price, or the unitary variable production cost. Once the relevant costs have been modeled, the function of the total cost depending on Q can be computed, summing them up. Then, in order to find the EOQ, we have to minimize this total cost function. It is computed by mathematically differentiating the function on Q and equaling the result to zero. The resulting EOQ formula is the one showed in the picture. This formula has at the numerator a component proportional to the annual procurement cost, and at the denominator a component proportional to the annual inventory carrying cost. Therefore, the higher the procurement cost with respect to the inventory carrying cost, the higher the EOQ. It is cheaper to minimize the number of orders and then to order large quantities. Vice versa, the higher the inventory carrying cost with respect to the procurement cost, the lower the EOQ. It is cheaper to reduce the average inventory and then to order small quantities. In order to better understand the methodology, I'm going to show you an example of how to calculate the EOQ. The input data of the problem are the unitary procurement cost, which is 8 euro per order, the yearly demand, which is 4,000 pieces, the inventory carrying cost expressed as a percentage of the item value, which is 20%, the unitary price of the item, which is 50 euros. The EOQ is computed as the square root of the ratio between two parts. At the numerator, the product between the unitary procurement cost, 8 euros per order, and the yearly demand, 4,000 pieces per year, multiplied by 2. At the denominator, the product between the inventory carrying cost expressed as a percentage of the item value, 20% of the price of the item, and the unitary item price, 50 euro per piece. Making the computations, the resulting EOQ is 80 pieces. Once the optimization about the reorder point model has been clarified, we can switch to the periodic review one. With regard to this second model, the optimization consists in finding the optimal time interval between two subsequent orders. The same assumptions of the EOQ model optimization must be considered. The order interval can be determined either for each item separately. In this case, the optimality is determined by considering the relevant cost for the item, or for all the items that are jointly purchased. In this case, the optimality is determined by minimizing the sum of the cost of all the items jointly purchased. Starting from the single item case, the order time interval is calculated based on the EOQ, which, even if not corresponding to the quantity that will be ordered, is taken as a reference since it is the quantity associated to the minimum yearly total cost. This value has to be divided by the yearly demand, thus obtaining the time window between two consecutive orders. Considering instead the multi-item case, the formula to find the optimal order interval is the same of the previous case, but with some differences. First, the yearly procurement cost is composed by a fixed part corresponding to the common cost for procuring an order, and a variable one, which is the sum of unitary procurement costs of the different items. Second, the overall cost of goods is computed as the sum of the single item costs. In this lecture, we have seen how to define the optimal order quantity for the reorder point model and how to define the optimal order interval for the periodic review one.